the most important event yet towards becoming self-sufficient, though the president is only improving 5% of the movement to 46,000.
What about you, Trey? You mind?
We'll
get you in a shower too.
Oh, okay. Just make sure I'm not saying it like girl.
Yeah, shower.
I was about to do something. I can't remember. Talking about Dr. Ross.
Yeah,
just some coffee.
It's just a long walk. To get ready to still make yourself a home.
I'm taking notes, Greg. I'm taking notes, which I've watched you, so, you know, it's paying off.
Yeah, actually, I'm at that point where I need to accomplish all the things that you said.
Yeah. Well, we all do. Even teenagers, you're thinking about suicide.
Oh, yeah. One of these is in a Broadway play for a movie that's in suicide.
Welcome back on to 20 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3,
7:30 now on your Wednesday morning, and just a couple of stars celebrating their birthday today, September 10th. Madonna's hubby, director Guy Ritchie, is turning the big 4.
And actor Ryan Phillippe blows out 36. Every 60 seconds, there are two deaths by suicide. Suicide is an epidemic that is especially prevalent among our young people. So joining me now to fight to prevent suicide, he is the author of Impact, How to Get Noticed, Motivate Millions, and Make a Difference in the Emerging World, is Kenneth. Welcome, Ken. Welcome to the program. What is going on in our society? The young people, future generations, are taking their own lives.
Well, there's a noisy world out there, you know, and most people don't think that they really make a difference. The truth is that we all make a difference. We all touch thousands and thousands of lives every single day. And people need to realize that they do make a difference. And we need to get that message out very young.
So you say that there's a disconnect to the young people there. They are growing up indeed in a noisy world with iPods and all the pop culture. They're failing to realize that they can make a difference.
That's right. And it's the little things in life that make a difference. It's not the big things, you know, that you would think would make a huge impact in somebody's life. It's the little things that make a difference.
Let's help parents and friends of teenagers who may be in pain. And let's tell these parents, what are the warning signs that maybe a youngster, teenager, is thinking about taking his own life?
Well, there's all kinds of warning signs. Really, you know, it's all about disconnect. It's people that have declining grades in school, they're disinterested in their favorite activities, or they're withdrawing from their family, or their health habits are changing, or they don't respond well to praise. Those kinds of things really are warning signs that we need to stand up and pay attention.
And you also said that there's other things, warning signs to pay attention to, something, things like substance abuse, sleep changes, changing in eating habits, neglected hygiene. How can a parent or loved one tell if this is what's happening, if they're just going through that phase and find themselves, or maybe they're going through going down the road with an issue?
You know, what we need to do is make a real connection with the medical group and realize that if we have that real connection, we can sense whether or not they're disconnected. They're tuning out, checking out of their whole lives, and we can sense that. So just pay attention and listen.
Listen, let's go to what people should do, of course. You say that there are four simple steps that we can take to sort of make that connection to your really strength. What are they?
We use the word give. So G is for greet and meet. Make that real connection. You know, look somebody in the eye, say hello to them. Often at times that's going to make a huge difference. And then you want to get involved. You know, there are all kinds of organizations that are working now to prevent teen suicide. You get involved with those. But don't let people check out. Don't let them just go off and do their own thing without taking others.
Validate others. What do you mean by that?
Validate others. You know, we all realize when we make a difference, they're all important, that what we do matters. And that's why people want to give up.
Yeah. And also you said empathize. Empathize. What do you mean by that? Empathize.
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 Yeah, so what we want to do is we really want to understand that we can't do it. Everybody's problems. Problems out there are tremendous. And it really makes a difference if somebody can just relate to the problem, realize that they're not the only person.
Okay, Ken McArthur.